Welcome to Toro NSN's Training in 10, an innovative self-paced training module that allows you to get trained and get going. Today's topic is the course report. While this presentation is focused on Lynx 4.1 versions and higher, the principles apply to most versions of Lynx. Covered in this training in 10 is the course report. It's going to cover sorting, holes, area and station levels, the completed at, automatic irrigation, manual irrigation, stations on hold, disabled, and the current alerts. Here is the course report screen, and we will zoom into each individual item that we will be discussing. The course report allows the user to sort this information 5 different ways. By default, all information is displayed. You could sort the information by just the manual, or you could sort it by stations that ran less or more than their allotted time, stations that are placed on hold, and stations that have been disabled. The disabled is only available for a complete VP system. Across the top of the screen, we can see when the irrigation cycle will complete watering. We also can check when the last time the system was updated. And if that time has passed, we can click the refresh button to pull in new information. Along the left-hand side of the screen is the area names for the programs and the complete at time for each of these programs. Let's zoom in and get a closer look at the bent grass nursery program. As we've zoomed into the program level, the first column we discuss is the completed at column. This shows when the irrigation will finish its cycle. The next three columns are for automatic irrigation. The running column shows the number of stations currently still irrigating for automatic. The completed column shows the number of stations that have completed their irrigation automatic cycle. The next column is the plus and minus. This will show any stations that have ran more or less than their scheduled time. Many times a communication failure can cause a minus. If the runtime within the satellite is changed after synchronization, this can cause a plus number. With the utilization of the dynamic drill down, we can drill from the program level into the individual hole level, such as this one, 12th hole nursery bent. It also then shows when that is going to complete on that hole, how many stations are currently irrigating for that program on that hole, how many stations have reached their completion within that program on that hole, and if there are any plus minuses for the stations within that hole. Let's utilize the dynamic drill down to drill down to the individual station level. The station tag is identified for those stations. Next to that is the completed at time. This is what time the individual station will complete its irrigation cycle. Next to that is the running column. The drop cascades down for each individual station that is currently irrigating. The completed time for each station is the runtime that the station irrigated. Also, there is the plus minus column for any stations that ran more or less than they were scheduled. The next set of columns are for manual irrigation. links documents manual irrigation that is run from the central, from the apps, from the radio, or from the faceplate operation in the field. With manual irrigation being documented in links, it also lines up as automatic, showing the area, when that area will finish irrigating. It also has a running column, how many stations are running manually. It also has a completed column to show the number of completed stations in manual irrigation, as well as the plus minus column at the area level. Drilling into the station level in manual irrigation gives you the same information as automatic. The station tag, the completed time of the individual station, and if it's running a scrolling water drop, how long the station has irrigated, and if there are any plus or minus numbers. If there is a red drop on the course report, this is an indication that that program did not irrigate as scheduled. If there is a red shadow, that gives you an indication that within that area, either stations within that hole or just individual stations have not irrigated as scheduled. Drill in to the hole level. If this drop is red, that is an indication that the program within that hole did not irrigate as scheduled. If it has a red shadow, that is an indication that a certain number of stations did not irrigate as originally scheduled. Here, there are four stations that did not irrigate as originally scheduled. Drilling down into the station level will show you if stations have irrigated as they were scheduled. The red drop indicates stations that did not irrigate as scheduled. The plus minus column shows you how much less than scheduled those stations irrigated. Since Lynx also monitors manual irrigation from the central faceplates, apps, and the handheld radio interface, if there is a breakdown of communication, you may also see the red shadow or red drop appear on the course report if there is a breakdown of communication. If the red shadow or drop appears on the course report, then drill down to the hole level to see if you have a red shadow or a red drop. Again, the red drop indicates that all stations within that area on that hole did not irrigate as scheduled. If it is manual irrigation, it is also going to show whether the communication occurred. You will see the plus minus if stations irrigated more or less than scheduled. With the red shadow appearing at the hole level, drill down to the station level. At this level, you will find the stations that irrigated as scheduled and those that did not. The green drop indicates they've irrigated as scheduled. The red indicates that they have not. So double check by looking at that station tag identifier next to the red drop. Then check the plus minus column to find out how much more or less they irrigated than scheduled. The course report also documents stations that have been placed on hold. That is what the hold column now indicates. And at the area level, it indicates how many stations within that individual level have been placed on hold. You can then drill down to the hole level to see how many stations have been placed on hold within that area on that hole. Now, drilling on down to the individual station level shows you the stations that have been placed on hold by the stop hand sign. Stations that were placed on hold are scheduled to irrigate, but are held from irrigating. Thus, a station on hold is going to have a negative runtime in the plus and minus. The next column is the disable column. It is only available for complete network VP systems. A network VP system can be set up to monitor the solenoid operation. You set that tolerance of the amperage draw of an individual solenoid. If it exceeds that tolerance, by default, the network VP satellite will disable that individual station. The number of stations disabled will appear in this column next to the individual area. Utilizing the dynamic drill down, you can then drill to the whole level to see the number of stations that are disabled in that individual area and hole. By utilizing the dynamic drill down to drill into the individual area and then again into the individual hole, this will then show the specific station that was disabled. The designation for disabled stations is the universal red circle with the line through it. Again, this is for a complete network VP satellite, and the user can set up the current sensing as they need. The right side of the course report is the current alerts. This documents any communication errors and alarms that have been set up within your Lynx system. The errors and alerts in the course report have a timestamp to show you when they occurred or were reported. It also gives you an idea on where to start looking for that issue, i.e. flow report or communication error. Well, another 10 minutes has gone by and you have just completed another episode of NSN's Training in 10. Today's topic has been the course report. We hope that this Training in 10 lesson was helpful for you to better understand this helpful tool and that it helps further enhance your career working with the number one irrigation central control product available, the Toro Lynx system. Be sure to keep looking for future installments of NSN's Training in 10, the self-paced training module that allows you to get trained and get going. If you have any questions about this or about future training module releases, or if you'd like to participate in one of our acclaimed Toro Lynx regional training classes, please contact us by calling 888-676-8676 option 2. Once again, that's 888-676-8676 option 2. Toro NSN Training also invites you to follow us on Twitter so that you can get the latest updates on where we are, what we're doing, and the new training opportunities for you to participate in. You can find us at twitter.com @ToroNSNTraining and send a request to follow. A service offered by Toro NSN Training is NSN Focus Training, personalized irrigation software training with two options. Online, 1 to 2 hour blocks, topic specific, all done on the web. And in person, full or half day, addressing multiple topics at your facilities. Again, if you are interested, give us a call at 888-676-8676. Option 2, Toro and Toro's National Support Network. Count on it.